Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming to my talk. My name is Min Jiefu. I'm from Seoul National University. I'm here to share part of my PhD project to understand the coevolution of amphibian and the chytrid fungus. Can you hear me? So chytrid fungus BD is known to induce amphibian population decline or even extinction in many places, and the BD also identified in almost every continent of the world. In Korea, we also found that it's widely distributed, but in Korea we did not find the population decline because of BD. In Korea, we find the we isolated the local lineage BD Asian-1 from this local species called Bombina ventralis by our former postdoc. And this BD Asian-1 was suggested to be the ancestral BD lineage compared to global pandemic lineage by the science paper last year. So we were wondering how can Asian baby survive BD infection. So firstly, I wanted to know the virulence of BD Asian-1 comparing to BD GPL using a known susceptible species rhetoric currently. And then I tried to know the test the resistance of local amphibian to both BD lineages. Firstly, I found the hypervirulence of BD Asian-1 compared to GPL, as it can induce higher and faster mortality. Infection intensity also kept in the increasing pattern. And also I find the Korean amphibian, the three Korean amphibians exhibited resistance to both the BD Asian-1 and the BD GPL, as no mortality was identified to BD infection. And the infection intensity also just increased in the beginning and got cleared at the end of this experiment, or it's just maintained in a quite low level. So this result actually makes sense because Korean BD has stayed in Korea for over hundreds of years, and Korean babies have a long time to evolve resistant to the to the chytrid fungus, and in turn the resistance also can drive local lineage become hypervirulent. So next I try to understand why Korean amphibian showed the resistance, what's the mechanism behind the resistance. Whether the innate immunity or adaptive immunity, how they are involved in the resistance is still unclear. If adaptive immunity is involved, probably the MHC is not candidate to be selected for the resistance, as it's highly polymorphic and can recognize pathogen derived peptide and present to T cells. So previous researchers has suggested that MHC class 2 is associated to BD resistance. However, those studies are mainly based on genomic derived traditional cloning sequencing, and it has limitation to identify all expressed alleles. Therefore, I applied the next generation sequencing to genotype MHC beta 1 chain based on RNA, and I found high number copy variation in both species with similar numbers in average, and each allele has differential allele frequency. in host species. And I also tested the, I also tried to compare one resistant and the five susceptible Victoria, but I didn't find clear gene expression pattern regulated, except some rare alleles in the expressed in the resistant species. Probably those alleles can confer resistance, but due to the small sample size, it's difficult to conclude at this moment. Next, I'm trying to compare the amino acid variability in both species. So I calculated the UCA-BET variability. So it describes the susceptibility of an amino acid to evolutionary replacement. The higher UCA-BET variability means the higher amino acid variability in that specific position. If the value is twice higher than the average within species, then I annotated it as UCA size. Peptide binding size is denoted from based on human research, human MHC research. As you can see that the number of UCA size and the PBR size are similar, but UCA variability in the susceptible species is much higher, is significantly higher than the resistant species. Next, I try to test how MHC was selected in both species. So I tested the five parts, and the results showed MHC in both species under balancing selection. But in the susceptible species, PBR and UCA size are under strong positive selection. There are eight positive selected sites and nine negative selected sites in the susceptible species, but only four sites were under negative selected selection in both in the resistant species. When I look closely to the amino acid alignment, and I found five of the positive selected sites in the susceptible species are completely conserved. As you can see, it's completely conserved in the resistant species. Interesting, there is one site, the 13th site is under negative selection, which might be associated to BD resistance. And when I look closely to the amino acid property, I found this site. It's charged in the resistant species and mostly are uncharged in susceptible species. As I looked through some references, they suggested that charged amino acid can confer higher binding affinity or specificity. So probably the selection on MHC to it has contributed to the amphibian resistance through selecting on some codons, which confer higher binding affinity or specificity. To sum up this study, I found the high MHC allele variability in both species. But I didn't find a clear expression pattern based for the differential VD susceptibility, and the allele and probably rare allele was selected for the resistance, but due to sample size, I couldn't confirm it now. MHC2 and the selection was on the balance selection in both species, but it's on the but the PBR and the vocal sites are on the positive selection in the several species, and the selection is likely to choose for better peptide binding sites or the better specificity. I would like to thank my PhD supervisor, Professor Bruce Waldman, and Dr. John Ives for the guidance for MHC genotyping, and also my lab members. Also would like to thank my dogs. Maybe adaptive immunity do not need to be activated.